Is it difficult or different for you now? You used to be an opposition leader. Now you're prime minister of a country. Clearly, you'd have to compromise one way or another with your own values. Do you see that as a challenge?
Yes, it is. Frankly, it is, because there are things that you have to be more cautious or circumspect in expressing your views. I tend to joke with my foreign minister because every time I speak off the cuff, he gets a bit nervous. I understand, of course, but I think generally, of course, because we are living in a multilateral relationship, yes, and therefore there must be. But certain fundamental principles must be at least accepted. That's why I'm known to be a resilient, because other than fundamental issues, ethics, issues of justice, issues of morality, cannot be compromised too far, because otherwise then you are degrading the human values.
Many don't know that you were once a Rizal scholar. Is that accurate?
Well, I mean, I'm a student of...
But what is it about Jose Rizal, our national hero? What is it about his life that you can relate with so much?
Well, he is a tragic life, not only a national hero. I consider him precursor of Asian Renaissance. He talks himself as a wanderlust Malay. He talks of the region very comfortably. And he comes about not only just as a freedom fighter in a sense, but he's also the philosophical construct about the strength of the indigenous values, the rejection of this colonial mindset of condescending towards the colonized, and touching on fundamental values like justice and compassion and tolerance, which is so critical.
Do you see yourself as a Jose Rizal-like? Do you have the same characteristics? Do you feel?
Well, there's a huge gap between these personalities. but of course, I've read most of his works, and some, including Nolimi Thangari, have been translated into Bahasa, the national language. I used, even in the University of Philippines lecture, the indolence of the Filipinos, because that gives really the spiritual strength of the Filipino nation against the might of the colonizers, and only through indigenous resolve that you can and dignity you can actually free the society and move forward. So I think in that sense I'm a resilient, but otherwise I'm a small fry.